Hi guys, welcome back to another example of using CAMAssist. Today we are going to run a part where we don't run CAMAssist on the full geometry. This is a cast part that only requires machine finishes on certain surfaces. Our designer has provided two versions of the CAD part, a casting body and a finished machined part. We are going to use the casting body as the stock and then reference the machined part for the surfaces we will machine. We've put these bodies in separate levels in Mastercam to keep our file organized. Before we run CAMAssist, let's use the CloudNC Soft Jaw Designer to help us create some fixtures for machining. This cast part isn't really suitable for simple work holding in a vise, so some custom soft jaws for each operation will be helpful. The Soft Jaw Designer is super easy to use. All we have to do in this case is define the part. We will use the casting body for this, the spindle direction, and the jaw opening direction. We are using the Soft Jaw Designer to define the jaw geometry, but if we had solid bodies, we could select those to define the jaws. Once we are ready, we just hit the green check button and let the Soft Jaw Designer process the part. We sped up the video a little bit here. The Soft Jaw Designer will ensure that our part is secure and that the jaws can open effectively around the part geometry. In this case, we want to add a bit more height to the jaw body. The reason for this is we want to be clamping onto the vertical surfaces of the casting, not just the rounded areas of the part. We could rerun the designer, but instead we will just use the pull transform tools in Mastercam to correct the jaw geometry. We will just add a quarter inch more to each jaw body. We won't set up the machining of the jaws in this example, but CAMAssist would definitely be a way to speed that process up. Now that we have the jaws for the first operation, let's create a view in Mastercam. We'll call it Op 1. Okay, we will run the Soft Jaw Designer again for the second operation, so we just pick the part, the spindle direction, and the jaw opening direction. For the depth, or Z level, we are just going to put in a quarter of an inch because this operation doesn't have to hold the part as deep as the first op. Now we have four jaw bodies. Two for each operation. We will move these into separate levels in Mastercam just to keep the file organized. One level will be called Soft Jaw Op 1, and the other will be Soft Jaw Op 2. With the levels well organized, let's move on to adding a view for Op 2 as well. In this case, we just had views with the casting body shown, but it might be helpful to add views with the finished machined part visible as well. This is really up to how you prefer to organize your Mastercam processes.
Next, we need to set up machine groups. We are going to add a separate machine group for Op 1 and another for Op 2. In each of the machine groups, we will be using the casting body as the stock and the finish machined body as the master model. Since we are running CAMAssist for both machine groups at the same time, CAMAssist will be expecting the machine groups to be consistent. You can see that we had to go back and forth between the machine group settings and the level panel to make these selections. We also renamed the machine groups to Op 1 and Op 2, just to be consistent between the levels, views, and machine groups, but this is not required. This was done by changing the name field in the Files area of the machine group configurations. With the machine group set up, we are now ready to run CAMAssist on this part. Don't worry about these messages. Some of our levels aren't visible. For this part, we want Op 1 to use the bottom plane and Op 2 to use the top plane, but this will depend on each file and work holding situation. We will also add the soft jaw bodies as avoidance geometry for each setup. Avoidance geometry in CAMAssist is similar to a fixture body. However, hole making operations are allowed and the tolerance to the body is a bit looser. This is ideal for soft jaw bodies like we are using. Next, the key thing we want to talk about in this video is on the Advanced tab. Under the Geometry section, we are going to uncheck Machine Full Part, as the casting only has certain faces we need to machine to tolerance. For this, we need to set the levels to show the finished machined part as well. We will uncheck Machine Full Part, and then click the Select Faces button. Next, we are going to pick the faces in the 3D view. One tip here is don't use green to color the machined faces in your CAD file, as it will be a bit challenging to select the faces in CAMAssist. In this case, we are mainly going to be selecting the purple colored faces. We also are going to select the faces that make up the holes, which we did not color purple. There were a few holes, so we sped up the video for this demo. Take your time for this process and be sure to select all of the faces to machine. CAMAssist won't persist or save these selections. We also want to select the purple faces on the Op2 side of the part. For this part, there were a total of 64 faces selected. Once all the faces are selected for Op1 and Op2 and the other settings are ready, we can hit the green check button to run CAMAssist. We've sped up the video a little here, but these toolpaths did not take long to compute with CAMAssist. As this message shows, we have finished 64 of 64 surfaces. This number only reflects the ones we selected for this part. Let's generate the toolpaths in Mastercam and review. As we examine the computed toolpaths, we see that CAMAssist has only created roughing, hole making, and finishing toolpaths for the selected faces. The rest of our part will retain the casting finish, which is exactly what we want. If there were any edits needed to the operations, we could make them at this time using the Mastercam parameters or the CloudNC Cutting Parameters Explorer, or a combination of both tools. We will also run the output through Verify to check everything. Whether you want to constrain the toolpaths generated to specific faces for a cast part like this, or you just want to add a secondary finishing pass to a part on the machined, unchecking Machine Full Part in CAMAssist may work for you. Have any questions? Let us know in the comments. And if this video helped, don't forget to give us a like. We'll see you in the next one.